I'm ready to take a nettle sting to the eye. Wait. How's it going, everybody? I'm back, and I have a car. Ow! I looked on the map, and I'm hoping that the footpath is just here on my left. We're about to find out. It's somewhere here. There we go. Oh no, nettles. No one's maintained this. Oh boy. What is this? I had a spot I wanted to check out here. It's called Mark and Brook. I've made it. It's to the side of me. And as you will have just seen from that footage, that was the worst path ever. I mean, there was on my right, brambles, on my left, nettles. I was determined to get here, and I took hits. A lot of them, my right side of my body is shredded by brambles. I've got stings along my left arm. One of them flicks back up under my armpit, on my ankles, because there's those bastard low-level ones that you don't see. It was easier, genuinely, walking through the rainforests of Borneo than walking through that. It's nice here though. Embarrassed. I haven't done this for a while.
I'm going to show you by walking through here just what madness is. So first of all, this is a path, right? There's a farm up there behind me, as you can see. I'm on my phone because I can't do this on the camera. It's just going to damage it. Got an electric fence, first of all, going directly through what's supposedly a public footpath. So we're going to vault that without getting shocked. Now this is mild. This is mild. These are all brambles. Not brambles, they're like spiky rose thing. Hedge, ow, hawthorn, ow, 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 ow. Getting absolutely mashed. Look at this. This, it's everywhere. Look at my legs are just rammed up in it. That's the path. What? That's where I came from. Screw this.
Oppa. We've got a whole variety of video quality in here, and we're ending up with a little bit of vertical just for your pleasure. Oh, that's bright. That was a shambles. From start to finish, shambles. You got a nice little bit of preamble, something to laugh at. Now time to get to the nitty gritty of it and do the 10 metre walk. You'll remember me when the west wind blows beyond the fields of Bali.
You'll forget the sun in his jealous sky as we walk in fields of gold. So she took her love for to gaze a while upon the fields of Bali. In his arms she fell as her hair came down among the fields of gold. Will you stay with me? Will you be my love?
I completely got the lay of the land wrong. I came along this road at the bottom down here, all the way round walked all the way up a hill, past a forest, and didn't get the right location for where the sun was going to go down. So consequently, it's beautiful, but it's not... I've not got the light that I wanted. So we might try again tomorrow. It's been a fun little adventure to do that. I'm going to take some shots now. I might, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to try my new drone out, get some nice shots of this sunset with the drone, because they'll look nice wherever I can fly it over there. Ugh. That was an effort. It's day two, and we're back. I've come back to the same spot, but last time, at the end of yesterday, I walked over the road that way, and up over that hill, over the top, which is where I flew the drone from, somewhere behind those trees. Today, I'm gonna go back to a location behind the other direction, where there was an abandoned, ruined building. So I'm going to go check that out. Regardless or not of whether I see anything, I am going to do a 10 metre walk, and we just got that evening light coming in. All good. Let's go. Really am picking up jungle vibes from this one. Really nice area. Sadly, it is private property, all of this on the right, but let's see how far that extends to. There it is. I don't think I can get in. It's impassable again. It was impassable to get into the ruined building, and also it felt like they doubled up on the private signs since last time, so really off limits, which is a shame because that would have made a lovely backdrop. So I found myself in this lovely wheat field. Well, it really is quite wheaty. There's a part of me that wants to do the 10 metre walk right here in this field, in what is essentially a monoculture. And I promise I won't do the goddamn gladiator shot. Honestly. Straight out of Catan, I am in a wheat field. Theresa May would be proud. And I am going to do a 10 metre walk here. Wheat, 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 all around me. This is going to be tough. We are literally in a monoculture. I mean, there's a few pieces of grass, but the ground is arid. It's sand. There is nothing growing here. Remember, the reason of these 10 metre walks is, yes, hopefully they're enjoyable, but like, I want to push myself, my creativity, different camera techniques, different ways of seeing things. And that, to me, is stretched the most when you are doing things at their extreme, when you're already pushing something right up to the boundary. And I feel like this is exactly that. So For any of you who haven't seen any of the episodes before, what I do is I take a 10 meter stretch of land and I stick within that 10 meter line, and I can film anything I want within or outside of that line as long as I'm walking up and down that line. It really pushes me to try and keep everything I do within a certain limit. I'm allowed 1 hour to do it in, I'm allowed as much editing time as I want afterwards, and I'm only allowed to use the kit that I've got, and I'm not allowed to use the drone. Stopwatch. Are we ready? There we are, starting from... There we go, go! Everyone's got one of those lovely deer shots where it's just popping its head out of a field like this. Where's the deer now? Why aren't they there for me? You know? Typical, isn't it? I reckon we've overrun. Let's have a look. Yeah, there we are. 1:04. Let's stop. Let's go left arm. Please, when you watch this, be very aware that it is just a field of wheat. There was nothing else. So I hope, if anything, you can appreciate some of the simplistic visuals, simplistic cinematography. I tried to push the boat out a little bit. I feel good though. I feel like I maybe learnt a bit, maybe solidified a couple of skills, maybe realized a few places or preconceptions I had that were wrong. So that's what we're trying to do with this. Just good to be back out and doing it, and I gotta try and keep it up. 5 minute photos and the wildlife wonders, and you know, I've got some new things up my sleeve as well that I'm gonna make, so stay tuned. This is officially the restart of the channel for 2021. So please tune back in and follow and subscribe and all that malarkey. And yeah, I hope you enjoy the film. And I hope you have an open mind when you watch it. But I'm back in the car now, so until next time. Adios.
160,000 acres of coastal plain, close to the small village of Godney. I've heard that the levels were once a wildlife-packed wetland, teeming with life, a bit like England's Okavango Delta, so I had to come and see it for myself.
You know what, I've never seen an owl in the UK. I've never seen an owl in the UK.